Hi folks and welcome to DevTrends. Today we're going to talk about new ECMAScript 2019 features and what lies beyond. So JavaScript is constantly evolving and there has been plenty of versions since first release of modern JavaScript. And by modern I mean ECMAScript 6 or more accurately ECMAScript 2015. It gave us many and many useful features which facilitated our day-to-day usage of the language. Some of the features came via natural evolution of JavaScript, some have been taken from other programming languages, and others were brought by CoffeeScript. But more important that the release of ECMAScript 6 divided whole JavaScript language into the period of before and after. It was really prominent release which changed the way we use JS. But since then, weight and importance of ECMAScript versions has decreased to a great extent. Nowadays, yearly releases mostly include minor language additions and internal improvements. S2019 is no different, but still, let's see what it brings. For this, let's check this article by Axel Rauschmeier, which is prominent JavaScript specialist that does trainings and writes great books like Exploring ES and JavaScript for Impatient Programmers. So, two main features of ECMAScript 2019 are flat and Flatmap methods for arrays and object from entries. So let's see what it does, for example, for flat and Flatmap methods for arrays. Actually, these methods are already implemented in modern browsers, so let's check in Chrome DevTools. Let's open the console. Right here. Make a bit. So flat function of the array is actually like the flatten function from lowdash or underscore, so it flats the array and nested arrays provided in it. So how it works, for example, we have an array, okay, which contains other arrays inside of it, like 3, 4, 5, 6. So in order to flatten an array, we just use our flat method for array, and you can see the output right here. So if you use it, we can see the flattened array. But the main difference of the native flat function in comparison to lowdash methods is that this function accepts one argument, and this is the depth of array to be flattened. So by default it's one, you can see. And for example, if we have another array here, let it be like 7 and 18, you can see default function with default parameter doesn't really flatten all the array, but contains nested array. And in order to flatten this array, you have to provide 2 as a parameter here to specify a depth of flattening. So you can see. For example, if you want to skip the thing and just want to flatten it all, I think it's better to provide infinity here. And you get same behavior as you get when using lowdash flatten methods. So this is flat method. And as for flatmap method, this is really like combination of map function and flat function that is followed by the map function. So for example, if we had some array with flat map and we want to, for example, we got, okay, let it be number, and let's create a nested array here. You can see there is an output, because in a common map function we have like map on these elements and we still have nested array, but with flat map it's like map and then using flat. So this is actually the same as flat map function. here. So for example, let's multiply by 2 here. And you can see there is none. Why none? Because maybe this okay, let's it's flat map function. So you can see there is some inconsistency. So if we like make it, if we like multiply 1 by 2, we get 2, and if we multiply an array by 2, so we get not a number. So this is like the map function following by flat function, and we get 2 and none as elements of array. So it's valid. It's valid code. So this is how it works. And there is also another major feature of S2019. Let's clear this out. It's object from entries. So it is not yet implemented in browsers. So in Node.js, you've got polyfills, you've got panfills from entries, but actually this is the opposite of object entries. For example, if we got some object, let it be first name, let it be Excel. Okay, sorry. Think, okay, let it be just object called name, and second name will be last name Rao Meyer. Okay, so here is our object, and when we use object entries on this object, we get pairs of two arrays with keys and values in each array of each object element. So object from entries does the exact opposite. So we got this array, and if we got object from entries method here, like if we put this array to this object from entries, we got this object. So this is just the opposite. So other ECMAScript 2019 features include, for example, trimming a string from start or end, a special getter for symbol description, a pretty nice feature called optional cache binding, so you just now don't need to put an required parameter error here when you just need to catch without no output. So you can just do try catch, and this is all. Another great feature is a stable sorting of array, which is long awaited feature for JavaScript sorting. And recently Excel published another very interesting article about the future of JavaScript. In it, he writes about both upcoming features of the language and what he'd like to have. Among these are, for example, comparing object by value, like you can just compare objects like simple strings, like here, with a special operator. For example, another great feature is a begint implementation, which allows you to use really large integers. And worth noting that this has been already implemented in recent Node.js versions, Chrome and Firefox. Another feature is some basic functional programming stuff like do operator, which allows you to write everything as expression, which is pretty handy as well, especially for devs coming from functional languages. And probably the most anticipated feature is pipeline operator. So this is like passing a value. So we got a function and function and function and function, and we got a value in the first function. And the pipeline operator is like passing a value through a pipeline instead of wrapping it in functions. And you can see that there is our value, we pass it to first function f, then to g, to h, and it looks like it looks much cleaner this way. And another feature is, of course, extended our JavaScript standard library with modern features like modules instead of colon methods on object wrappers. So with all these modern language principles which better correspond to modern development. So as you can see, JavaScript also, it had a lot of changes in recent years, one step evolving and moving forward. But what really nice is that nowadays these changes are much more in control and have clear and fluent implementation process than it was before. That's all for today, folks. All the links are in the description below. Thank you for watching and stay trendy.